In this video, we are going to describe the retinochoroidal circulation from the fluorescein angiography of a clinical case. In this photograph, we can see the two superimposed circulations, and indicated with the arrows, we specify the retinal circulation. Through the optic disc pass the central retinal vessels, the central retinal vein and artery. Here you can see the superior temporal retinal arcade. Inferior temporal retinal vessels. Inferior nasal retinal vessels. And finally, the superior nasal retinal arcade. On the other hand, the choroidal circulation is much greater. As you can see in the image, the choroid has a large number of blood vessels. These choroidal blood vessels pass through the sclera through four holes located in the center of each quadrant. The choroidal circulation is distributed in the form of a spiral, a vortex, which converges in these scleral holes. It is because of this spiral, vortex-like appearance, that the veins that exit the eyeball through these holes are called vortex veins. In this image, we can see those corresponding to the temporal side, both upper and lower, indicated with the arrows. Here, we can see the optic disc area highlighted. And here, the macula. Observe the important choroidal circulation that exists throughout this area, inside the temporal arcades. Thank you so much for your attention.